Just tell me your fondest memories of working here.
Today.
since you've worked here.
The last day. I think National Cinema Day has been a good day for me. So one of the busiest days that I can remember, and that would have been a couple of years ago. I enjoyed that. It was just the foyer was packed full of people.
Yeah.
I think it's been good fun. When it's busy, it's good fun because obviously you have things to do that it keeps you busy. But even when it's not, there are a lot of people, and a lot of people here make good friends with each other.
I've really enjoyed my time here. I've been associated with it for about 3 years because I used to work within the audience at Butlins, Time Entertainment Resorts at Butlins. And since my association with Odin Nottingham about sort of 2.5 years ago, I've always sort of kept a close contact with it. And I was happy last year when I actually got the job as assistant manager here. Unfortunately, it was sort of last August time when I actually started working here on a full time basis. I've enjoyed every single minute of it.
Come on, mate. Bye.
John, do you know much of the history of the Odeon?
Yes, I do, yes. Yeah. Yes. Yeah. Absolutely fascinates me. The more people who inquire about it, I just had a gentleman who used to work for a company that used to lease one of the offices at the back of the Odeon. And it was such a privilege to have to take him back. He hasn't been in the building since 1963. Mm. And I just took him backstage there and showed him around. And you know, he's 70 years of age now, actually showing him around there, and all the memories came flooding back to him. And it's the last few weeks have been very sort of heart-wrenching really, because we've had a lot of sort of technicians and projectionists visiting us who worked here probably in the 1930s and the 1940s. And there's so many memories and so much history around here at the Odeon. And I've talked, you know, it's been a real sort of it's been extremely upsetting really to meet all these people, and you know, I mean, obviously they're upset because of the close down, and then again, you know, there's just so much history here. I mean, everybody's got a memory of the Odeon Nottingham.
Exactly. Yeah. Would you say, in your opinion, that the boom in home entertainment has got anything to do with the closure of the Odeon?
I wouldn't say that, no. Over the last few recent years, there's been a big turnaround within the audience growth within cinema. There was a downtime in the sort of probably mid to late, or mid-70s up till the early 80s, where people didn't really come to the cinema because of the introduction of films coming onto television, home video markets came into use. But I think over the last few years, I mean, all you've got to do really is study recent figures, and people are actually now coming back to the cinema.
When the Odeon actually closes, will you still be involved in cinema?
I'm still being employed by Odeon. I'm being transferred out to the recently changed over Odeon Mansfield, that used to be an ABC multiplex in Mansfield. Since the merger of ABC and Odeon, they decided to change it over to an Odeon cinema. So I'll be out at Odeon Mansfield multiplex there.
Do you see the closure of the Odeon as a sign of the times, or is it going to be something that just needs to be done?
I would say it is a sign of the times because of recent, with the multiplex cinema operations, the building at present obviously needs a lot of work doing to it to bring it up to modern standards. But alongside that, this building is a complete rarity within the cinema industry, because it is a traditional cinema, and unfortunately I see it as that. It's a shame to see a cinema like this go because of multiplex operations, but then on the other side of things, time progresses on and multiplexes are here to stay, and that's a way forward to give customers far more choice. A customer can go into a multiplex cinema, have probably a choice of 16 films at any given time, whereas here, with the way the building is at the moment, we've got probably a choice of six films.
Do you feel that the Odeon Cinema sort of led the way in the beginning?
Oh yes, yeah. I mean, Odeon Cinema is still the brand leader within UK cinema, and it's the most recognised cinema brand. It's still the biggest cinema chain within the UK, and hopefully touch wood will carry on to it as well.
Right. Okay, John Gowan, thanks very much.
Okay, thank you.
Sitter.
What's
the
flash
is going. Mr. Roebuck, your fondest memories of working at the Odeon? So they were.
I think it's the people. It has to be the people. All my staff. They're not staff, they're friends. Boys and girls and work. It's probably one of the common people. Not just here, but places like Doncaster and Peter and other places that I've worked in. They're all very special. And in particular here in Nottingham, we had a very difficult 2 or 3 months knowing what is happening to the place. They have been supportive, helpful, kind, concerned. I think that if you, okay, if you look at the Premier League, they live in like dying 12-month league. But my real thoughts and beliefs are with the people who have helped me over this last 3 months. And the people who have helped me over this last 20 years as well. They're very special. It's a people business. It's been a people place. That's one of the fondest memories I've ever.
When the Odeon closes, are you going to continue in the cinema business?
No, I have no particular plans at this stage. I'm leaving the cinema. I've served 35 years with no remission. I'm not sure that I would want to continue in a business which is changing so fast. I have loved it. I love the business. I do love the business, and I know that a lot of other people who work will love it as well.
Yeah.
It's been wonderful for me, and it should be wonderful for other people.
One of the things that I think a lot of people don't realise is that the Odeon used to be a venue for live performances.
Yes, that's right.
Any particular performance that sticks out in your mind at all?
Well, the live performances, by the time I came here, had ceased, but I have had experiences with the Beaumont Doncaster and the Rolling Stones. The experience I had there when I was a young lad, and I thought that was going to give to everybody. The boss said to me, he said, make sure you put some earplugs in. And I said,
me?
No, I don't need any earplugs. I don't need any of that. I couldn't hear for 3 days. Because the pitch of the screaming was such that you couldn't hear. So that's the only memory I have of that.
Yeah. All right, Mr. Roebuck, thank you very much.
It's my pleasure. Thank you.
Thank you.
After almost 70 years as a theatre and cinema, formerly known as the Ritz, and now of course the Odeon Cinema, we close our doors to the public tonight. As an ex-projectionist in the cinema back in the 70s, that's the 1970s rather than the 1870s, I'm proud to be one of the many people here tonight who are associated with this fine building. The company staff are very pleased that so many of you have come along in particular to share on this special occasion. And indeed, Gordon himself will be here to say a few words at the end of tonight's film. But as a special extra surprise for those of you who, like me, are fond of cinema going and the cinema going days gone by, after tonight's film, we've arranged a special show, a short 15-minute video presentation, which takes a close look at what this great building has meant to us all over the years and to cinema goers throughout Nottingham. I hope that you'll all be able to stay and watch that. So please feel free to stay at the end of Castaway, but for now, please enjoy what promises to be one of the most enjoyable and successful films this year. Enjoy the movie. Well, hello again, ladies and gentlemen, and thank you very, very much for staying behind after the film. We're going to move swiftly on now, and I'd like to introduce you to a person who you don't know, but who actually spent a lot of time many years ago filming some archive footage of this cinema and others. And I'd like to introduce you to him. He's going to tell us a little bit about what you're about to see, some archive footage of the Nottingham Odeon and other cinemas. So please give a warm welcome to Bill Freeman.
Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Bill Freeman and I am the Managing Director of Nottingham Audiovisual Services Limited. It is my very great pleasure to introduce this film tonight. It's called Cinema of the 70s. And I must say how grateful I am to Gordon Roebuck for giving me the privilege of bringing it along here tonight. And I do consider it to be a great honour that it is the last film to be shown at the Nottingham Odeon. The film is in fact an 8mm film, and it was filmed on a Bolex 8mm camera on standard 8 film in 1965. In order to show it at the Odeon tonight, we've had to have it transferred to videotape and digitally remastered, which we've done, and we bought some special equipment and installed it in the projection box. The film Cinema of the 70s was made by myself and a very good friend of mine, John Walker, who's in this auditorium tonight. It's a short documentary film about the opening of the Odeon Twin Cinemas in 1965. We entered the film in the documentary competition at the Westbridge Amateur Cine Society, and in that year it won the award. It shows the workings of the two twin cinemas here at the Odeon, and it also shows part of the cinema industry in Nottingham at that time and how it was declining. I hope you enjoy the film tonight, and I hope it brings back many memories for you. But before I ask them to roll the film upstairs, I would like to say that it really is tonight the end of an era. And it won't be without emotion for the staff and the management of this cinema when the doors finally swing to a close tonight. So, ladies and gentlemen, on your behalf and on behalf of the citizens of Nottingham, I would like personally to take this opportunity to thank Gordon Roebuck and all the staff here at the Nottingham Odeon, and also the people that have been involved with the Nottingham Ritz Odeon over the years, for the great entertainment that it has provided for us all. I think it is a magnificent achievement, and I would be grateful if you would show your appreciation by applauding all those people. Thank you very much.
Who for the last 20 years has dedicated his working life to this cinema. He's a man who's not only looking dapper, dressed to kill as James Bond. Please welcome our own movie star, Gordon Roebuck.
Ladies and gentlemen, clearly tonight is an extraordinary emotional night for everybody who has been involved in this wonderful entertainment business that we're in. I don't want to turn this into a wake. I really think we should be celebrating 68 years of film exhibition to the wonderful city of Nottingham, and I think we should be celebrating that. We shouldn't be getting too depressed about what is happening. It's all part of the history. And the history of the cinema is fascinating because Nottingham has been part and parcel of it for many years. It's opened in 1933 as the Ritz Cinema, this building, with Charles Laughton starring in The Private Lives of Henry VIII, which I think is quite interesting because a gay actor playing probably one of the most notorious historical heterosexuals amuses me. And he moved on through the turbulent days of the war, survived that in post-war, time was difficult, cinemas were closing down, the films weren't available, there wasn't money to spend on films. So that effect meant that many cinemas closed down. The big circuit survived, Rank, the Gaumont circuit, Gaumont British and the Odeon circuit survived. It went through to the 50s and significant things happened. A little thing called the coronation meant that the price of television dropped dramatically. A little thing called the Motor Car meant that people could go to other venues, could go to away football matches, theme parks began to develop. And other things happened to the business, which meant it was tough. So Nottingham then again, when you get into the 60s, the box office was supplemented by the Beatles, Rolling Stones, and live shows, all who appeared at the Odeon Nottingham. So once that occurred, something had to happen. When you got into the sort of 60s, some of the executives actually drew breath and said, maybe we should do something. And who was that? It was Nottingham. It was the Odeon Nottingham which was selected. It's an oversized cinema, it was divided into two, and you all sat in the 1965 original auditorium, exactly as it was built. And this was the answer. And sadly, it was, if you like, the first multiplex. Ironically, it could well be argued that it's the first multiplex that has brought about the demise of the Odeon Nottingham today. But in the 60s, that was just the start, but it was the first. It's part of British cinema history. We get into the halcyon days of the life of the 60s, sound music running for 2.5 years. We get into the 80s, disaster. Everything. Business-wise, this building did 188,000 admissions a year. That's about 3,500 a week. One thing happened, we dropped the price to 199. And 99p. And it was December the 9th, 1984. We upped the admissions by 96% for the year. And the film that started on December the 9th was a little thing called Ghostbusters. And that was huge. And we never looked back from that up to the days before. Showcase opened, which is another historical landmark, but we were doing 10,000 admissions a week. A couple of football clubs, not far away from here, who wouldn't mind doing the same? This is not just that is sort of historical bit, if you like, to where we are today, but I believe this business is about people. I think the people that are in this business, I mean, whether it be customers, whether it be colleagues, whether it be the media or anybody else we happen to be talking to, that is the heart and soul of this business. And it's the heart and soul of the Odeon Nottingham has been for the last 68 years. one of the characters that you meet, cashier, for instance, who gets a phone call about Friday, Monday, and says, "Excuse me, I'm woke." Well, I've wasted my bloody time answering the phone, but not. And Dennis's daughter's here somewhere, so this is for Dennis. Because Dennis, who's an absolute wonderful dawn with sartorial elegance, immaculately dressed always, on the front of the house. This cinema is chock-a-block. No seats anywhere. And this lady comes up to Dennis and says, "Excuse me, have you got to go?" He said, "I want to buy the best seats." "Oh, sorry, it's the best seats have come." He said, "Well, that's not good. I've come all the way from East Richard." And she said, "Well, that lady over there has come all the way from the West Indies, and she can't get in either." But the thing about Dennis, which I have to tell you, is that he was in the office with a dearly, a great friend of mine, and I had the privilege of following him, Ron Gordon, the late Ron Gordon, who was one of the highest and greatest respected managers that this business has ever seen, and he was a hard act to follow. But he gave Dennis's great list of things to do, and we're talking 13 or 14 items, so he went through them by the way, one by one, right the way through, all the way through. Dennis looked at him and said, "What about the smell?" And Ron looked at him and said, "What smell? It's a little gym." He said, "We'll be bloody by the time I finish this one." In the meantime, we have to thank Paul Schofield, who has been doing a little bit tonight. He's been he's the technical director for Odeon Cinemas, and I really thank him ever so much for helping us out tonight. He's had to look at last year, so he's really been as a sort of team for doing so well. I would also, I suppose, and this is getting near the Oscar bit, I'd like to thank my wife Cathy, who is here, and my Andrew, and my daughter Nicola, who rang me from Melbourne this morning. That's not Derbyshire, it's Australia. For putting up with this oddball of a man and the oddball of a job.
Yep.
But really, the people who have made this last few months bearable, because we've known since who's going to kill me. However, I'm brave enough to go for it. Has completed 25 years this year, and I think that is a remarkable achievement to have worked for me for the last 20 years, and somebody somewhere is going to bring a little bit of a down for Barry Nixon.
about the walk of thing, yeah. About the walk of...
Good night.
Good night. Oh, I've got to get everybody on, haven't I?
Thank you.